Hey guys, it's Rick Dom back with another Fidelity. I guess you could call this a tutorial. I want to talk about how to use Fidelity's business cycle analysis tool to go ahead and pick good investments for the current stage of where the economy is at and where the economy may be headed. So, right now, the channel is young, but it's at 7 subscribers, and I would be so excited if we were able to get to 10. But if this video helps you out, or if you learn something useful for it, please like the video and subscribe. It really helps out the channel and keeps the momentum rolling as we hit our first milestone. So, anyways, let's get right into it. To find the business cycle analysis tool, we're going to go to News and Research, Markets and Sectors, because we're really doing market research here to pick our next investment. And once we're there, we're going to go down to the US Sectors and Industries Performance, click on Research Sectors and Industries, and then we're going to head over to the Business Cycle tab. Now, perfect. This is where the money is made. When I just started investing, I was kind of frozen because I didn't want to pick a company that wouldn't do well in the current business environment, and I wanted to figure out how I could find out which companies historically had done well for where our economy was at the moment. So I wanted to give myself the best possible chance to succeed. And this was kind of the answer to all that, the business cycle analysis tool. So as you can see on the web page here, economies go through expansion. They kind of slow and then they go into contraction. It's a cycle. And the key is nobody knows exactly how long these cycles will last. Sometimes it's months. Sometimes it's years, sometimes it's tens of years, like it is now in our expansion cycle. But this tool believes that the United States probably is in the late part of an economic expansion, and at some point down the road, we're going to be due for a recession. So, looking at this tool and where it has us pegged, I want to filter by how these different sectors will perform for where we're at right now. You can see the green pluses represent these sectors will do really well, and the red ones represent they usually underperform. So, going through the late cycle here, energy, healthcare, minerals, consumer staples does really well. And I want to show you guys how to find investments off of this. So, consumer staples is rated as it overperforms for the late part of the cycle. And we can also see that it usually overperforms in recessions. Standard things that people have to keep buying, whether their money is really tight or whether they're doing pretty well in the late part of an economic expansion. So let's go into here, press consumer staples. We're going to head on over to find investments from that. And then just scroll down to view results and criteria. So this is going to take us to the stock screener page, which is an awesome Fidelity tool. I highlighted this in my video talking about Fidelity's top five tools for you guys, but this will lay out all the companies that fit our criteria of consumer staples because that's where we want to invest based on how the economy is doing and when it will eventually head into a recession. I'm going to change the market capitalization here. Mega cap and large cap are the biggest companies that are publicly traded on the stock market in the consumer staples sector. So we see all sorts of names that a lot of people should know. Walmart, Procter and Gamble, Coca-Cola. We can sort them by the equity summary score, how analysts think that they're going to perform in the next few months. And you see a lot of common companies here. And this just gives you a great resource to pick and choose based on how the economy is doing, finding companies that fit in that niche as to where we're at as a country, where we're at as an economy, and finding the best companies that you possibly can to make it work for your profile. Now, this isn't investment advice, but it's something that I used that gave me some great results when I was just starting off, and now it's just a part of the regular checklist that I go through when I'm picking stocks to buy. So I hope that this video helped you guys out. Again, you can help me out with just a simple like or a comment. I'd love to hear any questions. That's how I find ideas to make new videos, what you guys are looking for, what questions that you guys have. that I can answer. So have a great day, and we'll see you next time.